The Synology DVA Series models support real-time, actionable video intelligence. With advanced AI-driven algorithms, including face recognition, people and vehicle detection, intrusion detection, and people counting. Over 8,000 cameras are compatible with Surveillance Station, making them easy to integrate into your existing cameras. In this video, we will show you how to set up the face recognition and deep video analytics tasks, how to monitor live streams and receive alerts. You can find the timestamps of each section in the video description. Setting up a face recognition task to detect a person and determine whether he is a stranger, on a blocked list, or on a VIP list. During an epidemic, facial recognition can also be used to monitor whether people are wearing masks. Before starting a face recognition task, make sure the camera's image quality is 1920 by 1080 or higher, with a minimum of 300 light levels. The recommended installation height is between 1.5 and 3 meters, and the tilt angle should be less than 15 degrees. The recommended face resolution is 125 x 125 pixels. Adjusting the mounting height and angle can achieve better recognition results. Make sure the camera can capture facial features and the lighting is sufficient. The following conditions may affect the accuracy of recognition results, such as having a backlight, using panoramic cameras, or having a partially covered face. Before setting up a face recognition task, it is recommended to create a face database. Let's start by showing you how to add a profile. First, go to Surveillance Station, Face Recognition, Face Database. Administrators can create user profiles one at a time or import them in batches through templates provided by Surveillance Station. Click Create, upload a photo, and fill in the employee's information. To achieve better recognition results, a good photo should have the following. The eyes and nose are visible and facing the camera, not tilted up, down, or to the sides. The resolution should be at least 300 x 300 pixels, and the width of the face should be at least 75 pixels. Ensure the lighting is sufficient. Include the shoulders of the person, and leave some space above the head. Use photos taken within the 3 months prior, and update them regularly. After creating your profiles, you can add the profiles to a group and designate them to one of the following groups: allowed, blocked, or VIP. To add or manage groups, go to the Group tab. Next, create a face recognition task to identify and classify people from the live stream. Go to Task and click Create. Fill in the basic information and select a video source. To facilitate face recognition, assign a face frame color and click Select to assign a group. Users can assign groups to Allowed, Blocked, or VIP. Users can also assign colors to detect the identified event to quickly filter the recognition results. Set up parameters to determine the recognition result and what information to display on screen. Congratulations! You have successfully created a face recognition task. Once the setup is complete, you can view the recognition results in the Recognition Results tab. Use the filters on the right to narrow your searches, such as Target, Event, and Face Covered Detection. You can also search images to find related people by uploading a photo. If you are in HR and need attendance reports, you can generate an access report to help you complete your task. Next, we'll introduce deep video analytics. We'll be covering the settings and functions for the people and vehicle detection, intrusion detection, and people counting tasks. When you set up the people and vehicle detection, The system will detect and notify you when someone or a car enters a specific area. Advanced functions such as license plate recognition are also available to monitor who's entering and leaving your properties. The loitering features identify suspicious individuals and prevent robberies at places such as the bank or stores. Another advanced feature is crowd detection. Improve public safety by monitoring activities at places such as the subways or shopping malls. The camera should be installed between 2.5 and 4 meters high for the detection. The tilt angle should be less than 30 degrees. Also, face the camera directly at the object. Make sure nothing is blocking the object and that it's not too far from the camera. Do not use panoramic cameras. To create the people and vehicle detection task, go to Surveillance Station, click Deep Video Analytics, and then Task. Click Create. Select People and Vehicle Detection. Enter a name and select your video source. Under Settings, choose your detection target. Then select the rules to apply to the detection, such as license plate recognition, or adding bookmarks automatically to your recordings when certain objects are detected. Under Parameters, select your zone type and zone count. Edit the area by dragging the corners of the frame to adjust the detection frame. Events will be triggered when 10% of a person or vehicle enters the detection zone. After setting the area, select the information you want to display. You are now set up for people and vehicle detection. Next time someone enters without permission, you will be notified right away. Intrusion detection is designed to issue alerts when a vehicle or person trespasses a virtual line. It can be applied to dangerous areas, restricted zones, and home security. Before setting up the task, make sure you remove any obstructions so that objects can be properly detected. To create an intrusion detection task, go to Surveillance Station, Deep Video Analytics, Task, and click Add. Select Intrusion Detection. Enter a name for your task and select your video source. Under Settings, you can choose your detection target. When selecting specific objects to detect, events will be triggered when 10% of a person or vehicle crosses the detection fence. When selecting all objects, events will be triggered when 30% of an object crosses the detection fence. Choose the detection direction under the parameters. Create your detection frame by dragging the detection fence to the area you want to be detected. After setting the area, select the information you want to display and whether you want to ignore small objects. Your task is now set up. So the next time someone trespasses on your property, you will be notified right away. People counting gathers accurate footfall data with real-time enter, exit, and occupancy counts. It can be applied to monitoring the number of people at an event venue or business analysis. Before you set up people counting, position your cameras right above the entrances and face them straight down. To create a task, go to Surveillance Station, Deep Video Analytics, Task, and click Add. Select People Counting. Enter a name and select your video source. Under Settings, in Calculation mode, select the mode to count and choose to enable or disable crowd detection. Set a certain number of people under the parameter. You will receive a notification when the number of people exceeds the threshold. You can also set up the reset counter. Use the arrow tip at the side of the detection line to adjust the direction of entry and detection range. People counting is now ready. You'll be able to monitor the number of people that enter and occupy the space. If you receive a notification and need to view the recordings, go to the Detection Results to see which events have been triggered. You can do any of the functions listed at the top, such as play or download the recordings. To view your detection results, click on Report. Choose the report you would like to view. Select the counting type, source, and how you would like to display the report. You can also export the data if you need to save a copy. To manage your live streams, select Monitor Center. In the left panel, under Devices and Tools, find your Face Recognition and DVA task and drag it to the middle of the window. Now you can monitor all the tasks in Monitor Center. If you want to receive notifications of the events from Monitor Center, select the ellipses icon in Alert Panel and select Alert Settings. Select the event that you want alerts from by ticking the checkbox next to the events. When you're done, click Save. Now you will receive alerts in the Alert Panel. You can also receive alert-related notifications to your email, SMS, or mobile. Go to Surveillance Station, Notification. Select how you want to receive the related notification and fill in the required information. Go to Rules to set up what kind of events you want to receive notifications from. For example, when a blocked user profile is detected or when a rule is triggered. Let's recap. Use face recognition to identify individuals to improve the safety of your business. Use our DVA to detect suspicious activities or measure how many people enter and leave your building. You can monitor the face recognition or DVA task in Monitor Center and get notified when unusual events happen. With the power of AI analytics and SS Station, DVA makes it easier for you to protect your home and businesses. To learn more about DVA, click on the link in the description box.